That's a Belgian
top of that steeple up there, a lot of small windows up there. We used to use this as a lighthouse for a long time, about 1915. We were hanging lanterns there, directed from the harbor using that steeple. And you can also kind of keep looking at the steeple. You see it's kind of leaning slightly to the left, which is a little bit ironic because that congregation does lean to the right inside that church. St. Philip's up here. These guys originally were an Anglican church.
pictures. Former slave dwellings down here on the left, original. Used to be a lot more of each building's a museum. They'll start locking those up, unfortunately, in about 10 minutes. So I hope you had a chance to go through some of them. A lot of sad history there. Hospitality building here on the corner where you signed up for the house tour. That was the company store and commissary back in the sharecrop era. Building's about 165 years old. You may have wondered about this serpentine brick wall out here in front of the garden. Serpentine like that for strength. Most brick walls are a couple, 3 bricks thick. This was just one skinny row of bricks. If it weren't a straight line, you would probably push it over. Pattern after a wall Thomas Jefferson did at the University of Virginia is still standing. Copied it from the Romans. You can actually build a pretty wall like that and use about 30% pure brick. Stables over here, home to the ponies and Eden. Gin house reconstruction and restoration will be finished in a few weeks. Going to have a museum in there, a gift shop.
On my way. The night is beautiful. So are the faces of my God's people. The stars are beautiful. So are the eyes of my God's people. Beautiful also is the sun. Beautiful also are the souls of my God's people. Kumbaya, my Lord, kumbaya. Kumbaya, my Lord, kumbaya. Kumbaya, my Lord, kumbaya. Oh, Lord, kumbaya. Kumbaya, Gullah for come by here. Welcome to Boone Hall Plantation, one of the many, many plantations along what we call the Gullah Geechee Corridor that gave birth to the Gullah Geechee people and the Gullah Geechee dialect. West Africa, Senegambia, Gambia, Sierra Leone, Angola, Liberia, Nigeria, Ghana, they brought them from West Africa to these parts strictly to work the rice plantation. Me no eat no beans without the rice. Me no eat no beans without the rice. Red rice, brown rice, swimping rice, Oakland rice, Hoppin' John, rice cake. Me no eat no beans, but out the rice. The West Africans knew how to properly irrigate that ground so that rice crop could flourish. And them fellas, oh, they made their masters rich. Oh, yes, they did. Off of that product called Carolina Gold Rice. Me no eat no beans without the rice. Gullah, for I don't eat any beans without rice. In the Gullah kitchens of Charleston, South Carolina, and all along the Gullah Geechee Corridor, dinner for us is not a complete dinner if rice is not being served. Now, you can have your baked potato, mashed potato, macaroni and cheese, spaghetti, meatball, but if rice is not on the table, or dinner for the Gullahs is not yet ready. And when you burn, you scorch your rice, you probably throw it away. But we don't throw that away. We eat that. We call it a rice cake. And every New Year's Day, we have this special rice dish we Gullahs call Hoppin' John. Now, we eat it every day, but on New Year's Day in particular. But the Hoppin' John is actually field peas and rice cooked together as a casserole. And some people call that field pea cow pea, a little small brown pea. And we eat this Hoppin' John dish every New Year's Day, along with a bowl of collard greens on the side for good luck, blessings, and prosperity for the upcoming New Year. Now, some Charleston restaurants would try to get away with serving that Hoppin' John dish using the black eyed pea, but you can tell the difference because in that true Hoppin' John dish, your rice will take on the color of a bean.
Pictures write reports, never harvested. Beyond the cotton patch, beehives have these several places on the farm, and those bees pollinate. Keep an eye on the tree line. Used to see a lot of deer on the plantation. There's some wild turkey way over there, though. About a dozen wild turkey to wander around the place. Once the coyotes got here, not so many deer. Fortunately, no wild pigs or bears or anything bad. Boone Hall today, 738 acres or 300 hectares. Of that total, about 60 acres of it wetlands. Farm's only 115 acres. It's set up for education and community involvement more than being a big moneymaker. But plenty of rain. There's a third one. Yeah, I told you there'd be three. You thought I should pleasure boats, a great place to canoe or kayak or paddleboard. biggest special event here most years is a charity oyster roast last Sunday in January.
Thomas Finger.
So they put the wrong thing?
That's what I'm thinking. They just put the wrong name in there.